Hello everyone, today we will see another example of a contact in static structural using ANSYS workbench. So today we will see Clevis pin assembly. We have considered only half assembly here because this assembly is axis symmetric. In this way we can save time of calculation. So all the dimensions are given, all dimensions are in mm. Using any 3D software you can model this particular assembly. So the input are given like this. This is the yoke, this is U shape, and this there is a pin. So this is this particular assembly is used to join the two components. So material is a static structural steel. Young's modulus of elasticity is 200 gigapascal. Yield point tensile strength is 250 megapascal with factor of safety 2. So our allowable stress becomes 125 megapascal. Poisson's ratio is 0.3. Density is 7850 kg per meter cube and applied pressure is at U shape, which is 1 megapascal, and this end of yoke is fixed. So here we are using no separation contact. We'll see why we are using no separation contact, and by using this particular by solving this thing by the ANSYS, we are aiming to find out the maximum stress, directional deflection, as well as the contact stresses at this assembly. So once we comes to the ANSYS workbench, drag this static structural here. Engineering data is up to date. Structural steel is a default material with 200 gigapascal Young's modulus of elasticity. Now we'll ask for the geometry. We'll import the geometry. Generate it, and once we have this assembly with us, we'll see it by the frozen body transparency. So there are three parts. Now once we have the assembly, now we can rename it. This part is known as yoke. This is U shape. And this is pin. So we successfully rename all the parts. Now we'll go to the ANSYS mechanical. Now we are here at ANSYS mechanical. Now we'll see the geometry. It is made up of three solid bodies. Now we go to the connections, and in connection we found that contacts are already created, and these contacts are default contact, and all three of them are bonded. But for this example we want no separation contact. All the contacts are created correctly, but they are bonded, so we just need to change this bonded into no separation. But we'll see how the manual contacts are given. So we will delete this thing and go to connection, insert, and manual contact region. So first we will give the contact region between yoke and U shape. So we can rename it or rename it also. So rename it. This is no separation contact between yoke and U shape. Now why we want this contact no separation? In no separation contact we are allowed to slide the body, but we are not allowed to separate the body. And definitely between the yoke and the U shape, when there will be a tensile loading, the definite sliding will occur here. That's why we are allowing here no separation contact. Separation in no separation contact, sliding is allowed, separation is not allowed. Remember this thing. So we'll, instead of bonded, we are considering no separation. And now it's time to select contact and target. First of all we will select contact. We are considering contact as a U shape. Remember that thing, the contact is less stiffer and target is more stiffer, means it depends upon the material. But here we have the structural steel, so material is same, so we can select anything as a contact and anything as a target. So for to get visible this particular object, we need to hide yoke. We have first hide this body, and now by surface selection we are considering this as a contact region and apply it. Now see new window pop up with red color, means it is contact. Now I want yoke to be appear, so show all body, and I want U shape to be disappear, so hide it. And now we'll consider this as a target. This is as a target. So the contact is created between U shape and yoke. Now we can clearly see that there will be definite sliding here, so we are considering as a no separation. Now second contact, now we'll insert another manual. Now this contact will be between yoke and pin, so we'll rename it. Yoke and pin. Now here I don't want U shape, so I will disappear it, means will hide it. So I'll hide this thing. Even I hide the pin for visible, to get visible this hole. Now go to contact, select this surface, control button, select this surface and apply. Now contact is created. Now target, for target we need pin. So for pin I need to show all body. Now for pin it is not essential to hide it, means hide all, because we can easily select the pin. So here we have selected pin and apply it. Now see, red color is showing contact, target body is in blue color. So contact is created. And similarly, and now instead of bonded we can give it no separation. And now similarly we can create same contact between U shape and pin also. So third contact will be U shape and pin. So in this way all contacts are created. Now we'll move forward for the meshing. Give the automatic global meshing. Now meshing with us, but if we want more fine meshing instead of coarse, we can ask for the fine mesh also. So we can update the mesh from here. We can get the statistics of the mesh. See, there are around 13,224 nodes are with us, and there are 6,005 elements. So there will be 13,224 calculations will be performed this assembly. Now we'll go to the boundary condition. First we will apply the pressure. Pressure is applied on the U shape, which is of 1 megapascal. If the pressure is applied normal to this surface, but in opposite direction, if we want in a direction what we desired, give minus 1. Now due to that, see the direction of the pressure. So pressure is as we desired. And another boundary condition I'll provide, that fixed support. Fixed support is at yoke, so fixed support is also provided. Now ask for the solution. So once we get the solution, now we'll ask for the desired result. The first thing we want is equivalent 1 minus stresses. Another thing we want, deformation, which is directional deformation along the y axis. one more thing we will add here, that is contact tool. In contact tool, there is status already shown here. Apart from that, we will take pressure also and ask for the solution. Now we'll check it one by one. First of all, we will check it for the equivalent stress. At equivalent stress, we are getting maximum equivalent stress around 52 megapascal. We can locate the location also. So here it is maximum pressure, maximum stress of 52 megapascal, and 125 megapascal is our allowable stress. So we can conclude that our design is safe. Now for the directional deformation. A directional deformation is maximum of 0.7 mm in y direction. So see, so 0.074 mm is very negligible deformation, so it is considerable. And now we'll see what is the contact tool. At contact tool, we have calculated two things. First is status. At status, we will see what happens. In status, it is clearly showing that at this region there is definite sliding. That's why we have provided a no separation bond. And pressure in this region, maximum pressure is around 33 megapascal, which ranges from 43 to 33, which is within the limit. So in this way we can conclude that our design is safe. We can see more thing with the contact tool. If we want only yoke and U-shape region, so we can unhide these two things and ask for the solution again. Now see what you will see. You will see only this region where you can observe the sliding as well as you can observe the pressure. Another thing you can do, if instead of yoke and U-shape, if you want yoke to pin and U-shape to pin, only this region if you want to see for the status and pressure, this thing can be also done. Now only at the pin we can see how much pressure is created in the geometry, or in the in this way we can only see how much pressure is created on the pin. So this is all about Clevis pin assembly. In next class we will see another example of static structural. Thank you.